evening, and welcome to Off the Lip, the show about surfing and skateboarding. If you'd like to join the show tonight, give us a call at 831-479-1080. That's 831-479-1080. And now, here are your hosts for tonight's program, Neil Perlberg and Terry Campion.
Good evening and welcome to the Off the Lip radio show on KSCO here in Santa Cruz, California. Guess who just walked in? I know Mr. Jeff Clark is our guest here tonight, but rolling in at 1 minute to, no, 6 minutes past 7 o'clock.
Surprise guest. I didn't know that.
Richard Schmidt shows up.
Yeah, he was up at OB shredding today. Yeah.
That's awesome. Good to have Richard in the house.
We got Mr. Jeff Clark in the house tonight. And if you've been listening to the promo, I think most of you in the surfing world know who Jeff Clark is. If not, TC's going to tell you right now. TC, who we got?
Where do we start with Jeff? Well, before even this Mavericks thing, he was a Half Moon Bay legend. So, I mean, we could publicly when he discovered the surf spot. But now we got surfer, shaper, businessman, community leader, Jeff Clark's here. And it's exciting.
It's exciting.
Yeah, I mean, it's, you know, like we always say, we're going to document the history of, you know, whatever our spiel is. And Jeff's a big part of that. So welcome to the show, Jeff.
Thank you. It's good to be back in Santa Cruz. You know, I started out down here knee paddling a 5'9 twin fin.
What year was that?
He admitted that.
Late 60s. I was amazed that my parents actually let me go with these guys.
Who'd you go with?
Santa Cruz.
Who'd you go with?
Remember? A guy named Chuck. And
Chuck. Chuck, if you're still around, call in tonight. If you do want to call in tonight, 831-479-1080 is the phone number. We've got Richard Schmidt in the house. We have Jeff Clark in the house. We have Ben Carraz in the house from Operation Surf. We're going to talk about Operation Surf a little later on this evening. And we want to bring that back to Santa Cruz. It's very important to the surf community and the community as a whole to bring Operation Surf back and talk about the troops and how we can get them some therapeutic surfing in our fabulous Cowles Beach. So
great cause.
Our Facebook page has been blowing up because we're on now streaming live on the Surf Channel. At least we hope we are.
I'm over here running it right now.
We're on the surfchannel.com. So if you want to see TC or Jeff Clark, Richard Schmidt and the gang, don't look at me. The surfchannel.com. We're on Facebook facebook.com/off the lip radio show. We're on iTunes. We're in TuneIn Radio.
That's a lot.
TC, I want to thank you for carefully writing down those notes on the brown paper bag.
You know, everybody drove through Half Moon Bay to go somewhere else to surf. Nobody really ever stopped there to surf. And even before surfing Mavericks, it was so, you know, I wasn't ready to ride it yet, and I didn't have the boards to ride it. And we'd go to Santa Cruz. We'd surf the northwest side. We'd surf the east side. We'd surf up the coast a bit, Scotts. And I remember surfing up there. Just my friend Brian and I, the only guys out, and it's, you know, the outside sets, some of them would close out at Scott's, and that's big.
Right.
And, but there, you know, in the 70s, there just wasn't that many people out looking for big, powerful waves.
What was the motivation for you one day to look out there and go, I'm going to go surf it?
We surfed north of it, and when that spot got too big to surf, Maverick started lighting up, and you could drive around the point and park at the beach over there then. And so we drive around, and I actually had a 4x4. We drive up to the top of the cliff and sit at the top of the cliff and watch it break in a car.
Mm-hmm.
You know, it's probably not advised to do that now.
Right.
But,
I've seen pictures of that. McCrory had pictures of that.
And yeah. What did you decide to ride out on? What board did you first go out there on?
Actually, I had a natural curves that it was a 7.3, 3 and plus thick single fin, you know, and it wasn't what we know today as these, you know, 40 foot behemoths. It was 20 foot faces, medium to low tide, and plate oil glass, and really organized swell. And the peaks were not all the time, but they would break at the bowl. And I paddled out, and I said, man, this is the best left I've ever seen.
You went left.
Yeah. It was a left.
That was always your thing, huh?
I'm a goofy fan. And Jock Sutherland was my hero. And so I started, even when I could, I used to knee paddle, even a 5'9 twin fin, Anyo, everywhere. I was known as Little Jeff. Jocko was my hero. And he switched feet, right? And I'm like, I want to do that. I'm going to do that. So I'd go out and I'd practice in just closeouts, taking off goofy foot, taking off regular foot. And I just practiced that from, you know, time I was 12 years old all the way up. And it served me well.
So can you remember the first wave you caught out there?
Absolutely.
Can you tell us a little bit about it?
You know, the key to Mavericks is lineup, knowing where you're at. And when I paddled out, always looking back, getting your lineup, setting up your GPS.
Did you study for quite a while before you went out there, just for safety reasons?
I knew what I was looking at.
Or were you just like, were you chomping at the bit to get out there, grab your board and gone?
No, I'd been surfing offshore. Well, there's other spots that are half a mile offshore around there. And so being offshore and surfing a rocky reef wasn't out, you know, we can do that. I wasn't really worried about the rocks. I figured, it's far enough off. Don't have to worry about it. But I was really analytical when it came to watching waves break. Why did they break? Where's the, you know, I read something in one of the early surf magazines, probably by Ricky Grigg, where he says there's a vein in every wave that you can catch it earliest. And so that was my discipline, looking for that vein, making sure I was in early. And, you know, surfing Mavericks, you have to do that. You've got to be in the right place. If you're not, you're toast.
Who was the first person that you shared it with?
Big Bird and Tom Powers.
That day?
Yeah. I ran into him up at Ocean Beach, and they're looking at the swell that Richie took third in the Eddie Aikau in Hawaii. And the next day, drove up to the city doing a retrofit after the earthquake and ran into Tom Powers and Dave at Sloat. And they're looking at 30-foot walls. And Doc's trying to talk us into going out. I'm like, where? Actually, why? They're closeouts. And I told them I can show you a place that'll take all this power and make a perfect
peak. So you're willing to share it then?
Oh, yeah. Anybody that would let me bend their ear, I would have drug them out there.
So that was the day. And I really remember that day because I worked with Tom Powers at O'Neill's then. And that day he came home, he wouldn't tell us where he surfed. You told him to keep it a secret.
No, I just, I don't know if I did or not. But, I know that when Dave came back to Santa Cruz, you know, that he got a hold of Rich and... I think Rich can tell us about that conversation. Okay, well,
let me just introduce Richard Schmidt here for a second. Richard Schmidt showed up. Who invited Richard here? Brent? Someone. Oh, Van invited Richard. So in the studio right now, sitting next to Jeff Clark, we have probably the one of the most iconic surfers from Santa Cruz, most recognized, most complimented by the guests that have come into our show, Mr. Richard Schmidt. And Van's having fun over here. So, Jeff, can you just talk to Richard about what's
inside of this? Bring your Waimea board home, Rich. You're going to need it. And thank God I listened to him, because that spring, I could not believe what I was seeing. Paddling out there, and I had the same impression. Like, it was similar to Waimea, how it comes out of deep water, hits a boil, pitches. Unbelievable.
Okay, stay there, Richard. Jeff, hang on for a second. TC, we got to go to commercial. We'll be right back off this message from our sponsors. Thank you.
Attention all rental homeowners. Beach Nest Vacation Rentals is a proud sponsor of the Off the Lip Radio Show and is one of the fastest growing rental management companies on the Central Coast with an exquisite portfolio of family and pet friendly beach vacation rentals. Family owned and operated, they will get to know you and your every single need as a valued homeowner. Beach Nest will lovingly care and maintain your property, all the while use comprehensive business marketing strategies as well as full range of social media to maximize the desired results, especially in the off season. So give Beach Nest a call and find out what they can do for you at 831-588-6779 or visit them at beachnest.com.
We're all going on a summer holiday. No more working for a week or two. Fun and laughter on a summer holiday. No more worries for me or you.
Hi, this is Tim from De La Vega Golf Course in Santa Cruz, California. Want to play golf, but you're short on time and daylight? We have you covered with our 3, 6, and 9 short hole options. Start off 2014 with a complete golf evaluation, a swing lesson from one of our professionals, along with a complete tune-up of your clubs. We'll sharpen your game and lower your scores. We invite you to join De La Vega Golf Club, the Santa Cruz Sentinel's Reader's Choice for Best Golf Course, and take advantage of our complete 2014 tournament schedule. For further information, go to delaviegagolf.com or follow us on Facebook and Twitter or call the golf shop at 831-423-7214.
Hey, this is Steve Pereira, the beach guy in Santa Cruz, California. If you're considering buying or selling a coastal home in 2014, please give my wife, Diane, or I the opportunity to help you by calling 831-425-SAND. We've been helping coastal buyers and sellers find or sell their dream homes since 1982. We'll connect you and your luxury listing or beach bungalow with qualified and interested buyers using the right marketing mix and a little creativity. We'd love to share the stoke of our coastal lifestyle with you and promise to make your coastal real estate experience pleasant and successful. So give us a call at 425-7263. That's 831-425-7263. Or drop in on our website at lifesabeach.com. Kick back and relax and let us do the work. And remember, no one knows the turf near the surf better. See you soon.
Here we are. Wait a second, Van. You got to sit down for just a second. We're talking store, talking surf story here.
This is Neil, all excited.
This is Neil TC with the Off the Lip Radio Show on KSCO 1080 here in Santa Cruz, California, where we ask you to listen and be heard. You can also live stream on thesurfchannel.com. God, I hope that's working because I've been working on it since 3 o'clock. And what else are we on? Facebook, Instagram, tweeting now, TC.
I heard you're a Twitch.
I'm tweeting. I have no idea what I'm doing.
Hey, well, everybody else is doing it.
And if you want to listen to the show after it's done tonight, if you missed it, it's on offtheliptradio.com. If you want to call in tonight, we got guests here coming out of here. It's Jeff Clark, Richard Schmidt. If his phone ain't ringing, I don't know what's wrong.
The Niners are playing or something tonight? What's going on?
831-479-1080 is the phone number. Mr. Jeff Clark, you want to carry on the conversation with you and Mr. Schmidt? I think, Richard, Jeff Clark first comes to mind, if I was going to see you on the street and say, hey, tell me a few words about Jeff Clark, what would you say?
I would say I have the utmost respect for this man. He's got a fire in his eyes. You look at his eyes and, man, he's seen some things in his life and he has no fear. The waves that he's seen and surfed, just incredible. For him to be out there by himself for many years is, you know, I think it's one of the most dangerous waves on the planet. It's right up in the top five, just for the conditions out there and the cold water and the way the wave hits the reef. It's terrifying. So I utmost respect for Jeff.
Well, Jeff, you're out there by yourself. You had to have a couple close calls by yourself.
You know, when you swim in, and you've lost your board, and you swim in through the rocks, the tide's out, and there's a bunch of tide pullers, people pulling mussels and stuff off the reef, and you come up out of the water, and they look up and go, where did you come from?
Hey, TC, don't let us forget Felix.
All right, are we ready for this?
Go.
Trivia time.
Yeah.
As always, brought to you by Felix, a Sand Dollar Dinger Pair.
That's right.
Nickelodeon, you get two tickets.
831-479-1080, the phone number. What vehicle did Nat Young buy his mom for Christmas? That's the trivia question. If you call in tonight and get the trivia question right, leave your phone and name with Chris, our engineer. He will be, no phone calls? Here's the phone. It's blowing up. The phone's
all
blowing
right,
up.
There we go.
Call the number one if you win tickets to this event, Santa Cruz, which, TC, I get to introduce you in.
I heard you're going to introduce me tomorrow night.
I've got my speech planned. It's only 25 minutes long. Don't worry.
It's not a roast, is it?
It's roasting. Jeff, what is it like to surf Mavericks alone? Were you, is it ominous, dark?
Being out there, you got to know where you're going and what it's all about. And being out there is really peaceful. You're very calculated. You don't do anything rash. It's very calculated. The wave that you pick to go on, you're going to make because you've taken the time to do your homework and do it right.
And the worst wipeout was?
Being down so long, swimming up with the bubbles and seeing my kids ride their bikes and, you know, stuff like that.
How long were you down for?
Long time. You know, when the water starts to already clear out and then you're not coming up in turbulence, the big bubbles are coming up, you've been down for a while. And
yeah.
Terrifying. Well, when you start to hallucinate, I think you're getting close to the...
Mr. Schmidt, can you tell us about your greatest wave at Mavericks? Is there one you have in back of your head, front of your mind?
Yeah, the biggest day I was out there years ago, it was really hard offshore wind. Remember, I paddled out there, and it was just like howling offshore, and you guys were kind of watching it going, I don't know if it looks really rideable, and it's just kind of heavy. The wind's really hard, and I was just fresh off the boat from Hawaii, and I had my confidence. I had my favorite board, and I was going, I could do this. I was watching these waves, and I paddled into the bowl, and God, this is late drop, and it was really hard offshore, and just everything was so critical, and just made everything perfect, and God, it just felt so good just to have a wave like that and be on top of your game and be able to apply yourself to it. I'll never forget that wave.
Yeah, I'll never forget that day because it was windy, dangerous, and it was like Rich and I were feeding off each other, just kind of going, moving back and back, and it was you and I that were getting waves, and it's like everybody's watching you. You're fresh from Hawaii, you know, and Rich, you know, I've spent a little time in Hawaii with Rich, and, you know, his legend of the great white from the mainland is, you know, phenomenal.
Just true.
And when he showed up at Mavericks, we were just like, I was like, yes.
He's
somebody
here.
That has been there, knows that game, and now he can, like, you know, is he going to be the conduit to tell those guys that, you know what, we got a really legitimate wave here.
What did you learn from him? Did you learn anything from him? Pick up any tips, or was it vice versa, maybe? Because you've had the experience out there.
I think it was just comrade in arms, you
right.
know, being able to go, you know, have wow, he's going to push me, and yeah. I'm stepping up, and just that's what and brings out the best.
We've heard that. Not to blow Richie up right now, but we've had the young guns, the young Mavericks guns here, and they all say that Richie gave them the courage and the confidence to go out there and do it. And, Neil, how many times have we heard that?
Yeah, a lot.
Very consistent.
Yeah.
I think, you know, there's some big influence to these Santa Cruz kids that now are the dudes.
Yeah, they've got... Hey, right now we have Mark, who's been holding from Los Gatos. Mark, you there?
Jeff, I heard that yep. you took a few of your friends back in the days before the Santa Cruz boys went out there, one or two of your friends. Matter of fact, I can remember...
You just happened to be one of those friends.
Yes, Jeff. That was the most unfreaking believable thing the day we paddled out, and I saw you from the left side, north side, in the deep channel, take off on the left. I have never seen anything like that in my life. I don't think I've seen anything like that since, where you dropped in on that left, pulled into the barrel, dragging your hand on that bottom turn. And I was like, is that California? That cannot be California.
Yeah, that was a pretty special day. The tide was out, and I, you know, like I said, anybody that I could bend their ear to pull them out into the lineup with me, I just, you know, more the merrier back then. But thanks, Mark.
Hey, thanks for calling, Mark. We appreciate Mark. It.
It kind of sounds like how the North Shore was in the 50s or something, you know, like you just, anybody that was on the beach, come surf with us and different.
I'm going to move forward a few years here, and, you know, the deaths of Mark Fu and Sion Bolosky, how did that affect you at the time or and in the months to come as well?
You know, the responsibility really hit me hard when Mark died, because I was out in the water surfing with him. I talked to him. I said, Mark, what do you think? And Mark says, I never imagined it was this good of a wave. And, you know, when he said that, it was, you know, I just paddled over sets and sets. And just, it was like, for me, by myself out there, a moment of silence, just spending time out in the lineup. And it was like, okay, Mark, let's catch some waves. And I caught a handful of waves. And on the last wave, I could see the wind line coming. And as I rode the last wave into Mushroom Rock, it completely blew out, and it was done for the day. But it was this pretty special moment. And from then on, we started the Mavericks Water Patrol, and all the boys went to the K-38 classes. They got tuned up in how to, you know, actually rescue people.
Let's talk about the safety aspect of it, because you brought in here today your life vest, right, that you designed?
Yes, it's a big wave vest, and it's got two cartridges. It's got a release valve. You can blow it up to, you know, if you want the buoyancy of a regular life jacket, you can manually blow it up and just use the CO2 when you get in a pinch.
Okay. So the difference between that and the one that Shane Dorian has that he invented with the has the CO2 as well, but has a bubble in the back, correct, of the wetsuit.
Right. Right, and mine has flotation chambers on the chest and on the back of your shoulder blades. So even if you black out and you get to pull this thing before you black out because you're being down so long, it'll bring you to the top with your head up.
Okay, and the longest you've been held, when would you pull it? When would you pull that for yourself? Would you wait a minute? I'm gonna hang on to these CO2s right here. They're a little expensive. Would you? You know you're going down, you're going to pull it right away?
No, I pretty much wait. And now if it gets to a point where I'm pulling on my leg rope, or if I lose my rope snaps and I get pinned in a hole, my ears are about ready to pop and I've got no air left, or if I get the wind knocked out of me, I'm probably going to pull it.
Okay.
Or he sees his kids riding their bikes.
That's right. Chasing Mavericks, you like the movie?
I did like the movie. They used a lot of my stories in that movie. And, the you know, getting to spend a lot of time towing at Mavericks with Jay and playing in the ocean up there with Jay, it was awesome.
And comparing it to Discovering Mavericks, you know, the film by Josh Palmer? A little different?
Well, yeah, quite a bit different. Okay. You know, one's a documentary with actual facts, and the other, you know, Chasing Mavericks is cool. The story is Jay and Frosty. But that took all that took place in the 90s, not the 70s.
Okay. TC, what do you got?
I wanted to talk a little bit about skis, because I know they're not allowed out there. And what's your feeling on the new rules with that? Because it's kind of a safety issue, isn't it? Is that...
The skis are a safety issue. And that's one of the, you know, for NOAA to ban our jet skis out in the lineup at Mavericks. I mean, they say they're okay on a high surf warning, but a high surf advisory is when Mavericks starts breaking. And there's, like the other day, Sunday, there was 40 guys in the lineup. We need coverage. We need to keep people alive.
Okay.
That wasn't a high surf advisory day 2 days ago?
It was a high surf advisory, but they won't let you out there on a high surf advisory.
Can you sort out for us what's happening with the Mavericks contest? Who's running it? It seems like every year it's got a new sponsor, it's got a new group running it. Can you clear it up for our audience? Who's running it, when it may happen, and so forth? Is it the ASP World Tour? It's confusing.
Yeah, the ASP has nothing to do with the Mavericks Surf Contest.
Okay.
Mavericks Invitational is a group of locals. Myself, we have a board that's from Half Moon Bay, and we've run it. We ran last year's event. This year, Body Glove came in as a sponsor for long term. So we've got a 3-year deal with Body Glove. GoPro is stepping up, following suit. We've finally got the drama out of what you just brought up,
right?
Is the this and the that about sponsors. We got a really solid group, community minded, surfer minded, safety minded.
Okay, because last time you had it on the internet, it was shown live on the internet. How many people watched? It was a million or something like that.
I tried.
Didn't the whole thing crash?
Yeah, I think I crashed it.
Yes.
So you've got that sorted out.
We've got that sorted out, man. It's going to be the best broadcast you've ever seen.
Surf Channel. What's a Surf Channel? Shannon, better listen in here.
Well, with GoPro, I mean, we'll have a GoPro on every board, and it'll be amazing. I'm sure.
And the Surf Series. What's the Surf Series called?
The Big Wave Tour.
Is it the Red Bull Surf Series?
Is Red Bull involved in this thing?
Yes.
Okay, because it's been confusing. Every time you pick up the paper, someone else is running that contest. And
okay, I'll send you an email, and it'll be all straightened out. And then you can...
We've had guests who didn't even know.
Right. Do you think a lot of people, a lot of companies, maybe surf, have their hand out because they see money? You have a million people watching that thing on the internet. That people are seeing dollar signs for surely.
You try to set up a contest a half mile offshore with all kinds of protected...
To everyday society, do you feel paranoid? Do you think the government is trying to take away your right to bear arms and shove Obamacare down your throat? These are symptoms of schizophrenia. Schizophrenia is a serious condition that affects over 2.2 million Americans every day, mostly in the South. But there is hope. Reading Skidmark magazine will help take the edge off. Skidmark magazine is probably the most American magazine, consisting mostly of skateboarding, motorcycles, and dirty jokes. But Skidmark is not for everyone. You should consult your doctor before reading. Side effects may include diarrhea, vomiting, poor wiping, urination while laughing, and impotence. Get the Skidmark magazine app on iTunes or a paper subscription at skidmarkskatemag.com.
Greetings, Off the Lip fans. Peter Mel here from Freeline Design Surf Shop Santa Cruz. With the holidays behind us, Freeline wants to start the year off with some good deals in 2014. We still have a great stock of high-end turbo bodyboards priced at 25% off. We also have a great collection of new surfboards starting at $399. And with over 200 boards in stock, we got lots to choose from. As always, wetsuits from Excel, O'Neill, Quicksilver, and Hotline help fill the shop. Stop by 821 41st Avenue, one block up from the Hook. Freeline Design Surf Shop, surfing Santa Cruz since 1969. Follow us on Facebook and Twitter.
To find success with your New Year's resolution to get in better mental and physical shape, visit Pure Power Yoga at 1440 41st Avenue, Capitola, where sweating is so good for you as it detoxifies and cleanses impurities from the inside out, improving your cardiovascular health and the condition of your skin. Lose weight as the body is heated and fat becomes water soluble and exits the body through sweat as you burn as much as 300 calories per hour. Friendly staff, a pristine studio and the solution for a new you, where they invite you to try their new student special of $40 for 30 days of unlimited hot yoga and Pilates classes. For further information, go to www.purepoweryoga.net.
We are back. This is Neil and TC with Off the Lip Radio Show. You're listening to on KSCO 1080 AM here. Chris, our engineer, doing a wonderful job as usual. We're going to blow him up a little bit. We want to thank Billy Graff for not being here tonight because he blew up in here today this afternoon, if you heard about that.
I heard he had a little temper tantrum.
Billy went off this afternoon.
Oh, boy.
Billy blew up a little bit. But anyway, thanks, Billy, for putting together all the commercials on this show. We have a great time doing it. And thanks to Julie from Toyota Santa Cruz coming in here today. Did a new commercial. We are stoked to have Julie from Toyota Santa Cruz as part of the show. The time is almost up, and here we go. I got Jeff Clark in the house. I got Richard Schmidt here.
It was really interesting on the break hearing about what's going on with this contest, and that's almost a show in itself.
Do you want to go on a little bit further about the contest? Is it going to be, are you partnering with Eddie Aikau contest, or is it just standalone event?
A standalone event, just like the Eddie is. We're a standalone event. We have a great group of people. We have great sponsors. Body Glove has stepped up for a 3-year deal.
And you can send me that information so I can get it on the Facebook page and the website so people can have an understanding of what the hell's going on.
Absolutely. This is not an ASP event. This is a standalone Mavericks Invitational by Body Glove.
Very cool. In the hot seat right now, drove up from San Luis Obispo today, I believe, Mr. Van Carrazza. Van Carrazza has been the mainstay, the point of contact, the head of a very important event here in Santa Cruz called Operation Surf. I was a part of it for a couple of years, had a great time, have unbelievable memories of these wounded soldiers have come back from Afghanistan and Iraq, amputees. They get to go surfing, they get to enjoy Santa Cruz, the restaurants, the dinners, the lunches, they get to enjoy the surf. Amazing event. And Van's here for a reason tonight, and we want to give him a little bit of airtime. And Van, tell us why you're here.
Well, first of all, thanks for having me up here to expose the message out to the community about Operation Surf. You know, Operation Surf is, designed to use, the joy and the healing aspects of the ocean as surfing to help our wounded overcome their perceived challenges. And this will be our fourth year up here in Santa Cruz, and it's been a really awesome event.
And Richard Schmidt's been a part of that, big part of that course.
We partner up in every area we go. We partner up with the local surf school, and obviously Richard Schmidt Surf School is the best around the area. So I want to make sure that, plus me and Richard have been friends for 25 years, and we've been surfing together for quite a long time too. So, it's really important. He's my mentor and all the teaching aspects that I do, and it's the quality is what we bring, and that's what we want to keep on going is the quality with this event. And so
what do you think the soldiers that have come here to surf, some of the recollections you've had of what they've said about the event, that it means so much to them, and that they can
never had sleep during his nights. And then I talked to him and I said, what do you think, about Operation Surf? And he's going, oh man, it's like the new heroin. And I was like, What do you mean? I was like, right. Threw me for a curve. I was like, what? It just kind of like takes you away from everything. He goes, yeah. He goes, the doctors have been giving me all kinds of medication, to deal with my nightmares. And I've been here for 3 days and I haven't had a nightmare. And all I dream about is surfing.
That's very cool.
And that alone is just so amazing. But even more important, through the relationship that I developed with Bobby, later on, I was able to, we are really good friends now, and he was able to tell me through this experience that it's on our video on our website at operationsurf.com, is where he says that he was going to come, check the one thing off his bucket list, and after he got back from the surf trip, he was going to kill himself. So, and he didn't.
Richard, can you switch places with Jeff real quick? Because I want to ask you about Operation Surf. What's that meant to you? I know you've been a big part of it. Thanks, Jeff. Appreciate you getting up the chair for a sec. Richard, can you tell us a little about your experience with Operation Surf? And you've surfed the finest, the best waves in the world, and have taught thousands of people. And what's Operation Surf mean to you? The words from your mouth are going to validate Operation Surf, of course.
I just really believe in the healing power of the ocean and just the reality that these guys are coming from and the experiences that they've had. I just think it's the best therapy possible to be in the ocean. You're just so in the moment, you could forget about everything else, and it's just an incredible experience surfing.
Okay.
It's,
So, Van, you're looking for fundraising, correct? Is that what we're looking for?
Yes. One of the reasons why we wanted to come up here and, you know, tell you about how this program works for our wounded. But this year, our partnering organization that we partner up with, Operation Comfort, is going on a couple trips in 2014. They're going on a Vietnam bike ride to take some Vietnam vets back to Vietnam, and they're going to the Sochi Games in Russia. And so they're not going to come this year. And so one of my big purposes of coming here tonight is that I need to rally with all my friends and supporters to let the community know that we need to raise an extra, well, it costs about $5,000 per soldier that we bring out here for 7 days. And so in order to have the event come here this April, we need to get the community together to tell everyone, you know, that we need to get together and raise some money.
Okay, now, please give us your contact information. So if anybody's listening and wants to help out with Operation Surf and donate and bring some joy to these soldiers, where do they contact you at?
Well, they can contact us, of course, at operationsurf.com. And okay. There's a contact tab on there that you can get a hold of us. You can give us a phone call at 805-748. I mean, that's my cell phone, sorry.
Give it so out. Ladies.
It's 805-544-SURF. It's 544-7873, area code 805.
And you're on Facebook too, right?
Yeah, we're on Facebook. You can check us out on Facebook, Instagram.
And any size donation helps.
Anything.
So, I mean, someone listening who has $5 can go to and support it. Help out.
Yes, anything matters. And see, one of the coolest things is this community has been so amazing supporting this stuff. And so we want to continue to come back. And okay. So we really want to get here.
All right. This is Neil and TC off the radio show. We'll be right back from a commercial from one of our sponsors. Chill Out Cafe is the hidden gem of Pleasure Point and a proud sponsor of the Off the Lip radio show. The best place to grab some food before or after you serve. Giant burritos, piled high sandwiches, fresh salads, and piping hot coffee and chai. And my personal favorite, the delicious hot oatmeal with all the accoutrement. Come chill out at the Bright Red Surf Shack located at 860 41st Avenue, just a block from the ocean, where you'll always be welcome with a warm, friendly atmosphere and speedy service so that you won't even miss a set. So cruise down to the Chill Out Cafe, where they always roll the fatties.
Hello, I'm Schmitty of Schmitty's Custom Cabinets, Santa Cruz, California, 831-475-7809. Been in business since 1979. Few tips on saving water. Keep a 5-gallon bucket in your shower. Save the gray water from your washing machine. Reuse the water for your lawn, plants, and trees. Been doing this for 3 years. Have saved an average of 1,200 to 1,500 gallons per month. Just doing my part. So can you. This is Schmitty from Schmitty's Custom Cabinets, 831-475-7809. Remember to be kind. Enjoy the day.
Hey, it's TC from the Santa Cruz Boardroom. We all know the Boardroom as the best skate shop in town, but do you know the Boardroom as the best museum in town? The Boardroom currently has art on display from Jim Phillips, Steve Caballero, Jimbo Phillips, Johnny Mojo, and Brian Reed. There's 400 vintage skateboards on display and an amazing selection of vintage surfboards and snowboards for your viewing pleasure. Stop by the Santa Cruz Boardroom, pick up a t-shirt, pair of shoes, a skateboard, but come see the art. 825 41st Avenue.
California. Surf and Skateboard Central. Here tonight with Jeff Clark, Richard Schmidt, Van Caraz of Operation Surf. Again, Van, can you give us that contact information for Operation Surf? So if anyone wants to get a hold of you, they can write it down again.
It's operationsurf.com or 805-544-SURF. Or you can check us out on Facebook and send us a message.
Okay. And, yes, we're gonna pump that on Facebook. We're going to blow it up.
When's the date of that event?
Yes, the dates are projected for April 2nd through the 8th here in Santa Cruz.
Okay. And Jeff, you have an event coming up later on in the year with the Navy SEALs, is that right?
Yeah, the Navy SEAL Foundation. It's going to be called the Jeff Clark Invitational Golf Tournament held at Half Moon Bay.
Okay.
Beneficiary will be the Navy SEALs Foundation and Mavericks Water Patrol.
Hmm. What makes the contest at Mavericks a unique event on the but not on the tour. But what makes it a unique event?
Well, what makes it unique is we need giant waves. And so all winter we track the storms, and we get a lot of swing and a miss because, the models will throw you looks like the biggest swell of the year. And,
like this week?
And it'll disappear. Yes, absolutely.
Because like Wednesday, you told me I can't play golf tomorrow, Neil, because I got Mavericks is going to be happening, and now it's not.
Now it's, yeah.
Now you're playing golf tomorrow with me.
Yeah.
Well, it happened a couple of days ago. Were you out there?
I wasn't. That was Sunday, and I don't surf on Sundays. I go to church.
Oh.
See?
Good boy.
Attaboy.
And I wanted to say that Surf Channel is going to be carrying live coverage of the Mavericks Invitational the whole day.
Yeah. So, Surf Channel's on it.
And stay tuned.
So for the people over the hill, the techies, Apple came up with a new operating system. They called it Mavericks.
Yeah, go figure.
Huh? How do you feel about that?
Yeah, it was pretty interesting to, everybody's calling everything Mavericks these days.
And you called it Mavericks. Who called it Mavericks when and why and how that way back when?
My Little League coach took us out surfing when he used to bring us down to 38th Avenue. And he took us out surfing the little waves in the summertime inside the rocks at Mavericks. And he said, this place is Mavericks. And that's where I heard it first. Fast forward to 95, I open a surf shop on Main Street in Half Moon Bay. This white Hawaiian guy comes rolling in. He goes, why do you call your shop Mavericks? And I said, well, I was told that when I was 12 years old. And he says, well, I had the dog named Maverick. And this guy named Alex Montienzo goes, I'll be right back. Comes back 3 days later with a painting of the rocks, the wave, and this white-haired German shepherd. I still have the painting.
Very cool.
Yeah, that's the story I heard, too.
And, cool, and now, would you rather be on a surfboard or on a stand-up board out there at Mavericks?
Uh-oh.
Because I've seen... Here we go, TC. This is for you.
Dun, dun,
this,
dun,
this is for
dun.
You, man.
Hey,
and
when
this
you
is
have
the rest of you guys in here. Oh. Here's a stand-up paddleboard question.
Oh, boy. Watch the phones.
You
got to
crawl before you walk, and you got to crawl before you stand up. But, you do what you can do. Whatever it takes to ride a wave and keep that fire burning...
Yeah.
Whatever it takes to ride a wave. If you have as much metal in your body as I do in mine...
You're riding a
paddle
board.
Any way you can ride a wave. And right now I'm riding a stand-up paddle board in the heaviest days at Mavericks.
Is it easier standing up because you can see the waves coming to get in a better spot?
Well, if just like Rich and I and anybody that's put that many years in the ocean, when you're looking out at the horizon and you're that high up, you can put yourself in the best position.
Do you see Richard Schmidt on a paddle board sometime soon?
That's up to Rich.
Isn't he already on one?
Rich.
He's doing a little dance out back right now.
I think he's getting I think that's the itch they call that, right?
Oh, I don't know.
I don't know.
You know what?
I think Junior would probably kick him.
I see a whole lot of people with pretty big smiles on stand-up paddle boards.
Hey, there's no rules, right?
You name the rule. You've been naming rules since we started the show.
All I say is don't hurt anybody.
What about the numbers? We've had battles going back and forth. Here we go.
Yeah, the phone's going to start ringing.
Yeah. even Brent's in the studio is going to call in.
Hey, yeah. You know what? Even out stand-up paddling, as a stand-up paddler, I sound people that are dangerous. I go, you can't be around people. You're out of control. And so, it's all in safety.
That's all I have to say.
It's all in safety.
Yep.
Exactly right.
That goes along with everything, though, right?
It does, for sure.
You know what?
Hey, and one quick thing.
Sure.
We were talking about Steve Caballero. Got a call from him today. He's going to come on the show.
Okay.
And he's a very much so the Renaissance man.
Steve Caballero. Because the Surf Channel is starting a skate channel.
I heard.
And they want to do it from right here. Santa Cruz is a skateboarding capital.
Scott Foss and Jeff Hedges
are
Surf
Channel.
Planned.
We have Steve Caballero coming on the show here shortly. Next week, we have on the show the Guinness Book of World Records big wave holder. Mr. Sean Dollar's coming back.
Mm.
Surf Channel asked to bring back Sean Dollar. We're bringing back Sean Dollar. But for right now, we want to thank Jeff Clark for coming on the show. Ben Carraza coming on the show. We hope your phone rings up the hook. Richard Schmidt came out of nowhere
surprise
to come on the
guest.
Show.
Surprise guest.
Looking good, but Jeff Clark, thanks for coming on the show. We hope you come back and see us soon.
We got to have him back, because as usual, the hour goes by so quick. So, Jeff, you're going to come back.
Will you come back with us?
Absolutely.
Okay, I'll see you on the golf course on the first tee tomorrow morning with Mr. Tedson.
Absolutely.
I wish you the